across
a corpse.
A corpse.
Supine in the woods.
A rotting
body.
Blackened by time.
Burnt by a past known.
Known to no one.
The tattered skin desperately clung desperate to the thought of its form. Refusing release, but too weak to
weep. To remain.
Desperate propriety in the eye
of atrophy.
Its gleaming ivory ribs.
Like white flags
signaling surrender
to the treeline.
Stand in
quaking contrast to the encroaching decay.
It seems rock to the earth, Burgundy valley striving skywards,
the imperceptible shift.
From snowcapped peaks to chalk cliffs. The broken barrel of its chest, a fault line
rent
by an earthquake. The pull of my passion
seems only greater in passing, just like the gravity and entropy
that drag the flesh off the corpse and into the earth. Maybe that's where the idea of hell came from.
I witnessed this body. I witnessed
alone.
This body
alone.
Alone.
Isolated.
Isolated.
On the forest floor.
I left it where it lay.
But believe me. This is not bravado.
This is not bravado.
I dare not spit at death, for I fear the disconnect
between this man and me.
I didn't question his name when he could be me.
He becomes a creature of my own device.
Not flesh and bone, but thought.
Words.
He was not a corpse.
He had brown hair like me.
Like me.
And calloused hands like me.
To understand why I live.
Every night. I repeat.